Hello everyone, and welcome back to Digimon World 3. I have some good news and some bad news, if you're watching this. This will be an extra long episode, but only because my last recording, broke, and I had already saved by the time I realized that. DX Story apparently does not like having the window open and closed repeatedly, or full screen and not repeatedly. As you can see, my Digimon had leveled up. I got a lot of money since that time. I'll show you the locations of the secrets that I got that money from. Down here, through here, and there's a secret here. Can't get that yet. Through here, you can go through here, enter here, and you'll get cards. Haven't had any battles yet, so actually I'm gonna see. If you buy from this guy right now, the guys over here will be using their endgame decks. Ah, I can card battle. Some content that wasn't in the last video. Hooray. As you can see, all three of these are the same. Draw Kalamon. I like to go right. It's usually it. You draw cards, and they get counted up. And you can use a program card like this. Draw a card from the deck and put one from the hand in the trash. Now I'm going to look through here and see if I can't use anything. Let's see. I wouldn't mind another Hagurumon. But I know that if I get rid of one of these, my offensive power will be greatly decreased. So I'm going to go with this. It's a black. I don't have any other blacks in my hand, so that's good. So I'm going to use this. See what I draw, and I can choose. So I'm just going to go over here and grab a Hagurumon. Now I'll toss this one. Pass. And I'll just play small in the speed field. As you can see, it hasn't let me use the other card. I'm going to win heavily. And now I can use another program card. In this instance, it'll be this. And now you can see the mechanic of this. In the US release, you have to remember if you have a program card or not, because you automatically start on, yes, I'll use a program card. And now, that happens. And you can see his HP going down. Same with mine. The HP is determined by the cards you place on the field. All the cards on the field, when they're done, go into the trash. And I accidentally pressed and I got it. This is a much worse hand. I don't have any program card to use, so I can't draw any cards. But I have these two. So, fairly useful. Fortunately, I don't have another Goburumon in my hand, so it's a shame. Now, as you can see, when I chose Roachmon, the black box in the bottom there went down. Champions and higher require mana, basically. Get mana from having rookies and cards of the same color of the mana you want. Otherwise, it's pretty simple. And I won. And then you get a booster. A is the worst. Can't remember what the best is. Let's see. Yeah, another battle. This one is a harder battle. And I got crap for cards. Now I'll just get them all. As you can see, this champion requires one red, and I get one from him. The mana does stack and carry over. So, if you want to save some mana, then you don't have to play a card that costs mana. And you'll have the mana for the next round. Now, I'm going to win. Yes, I'll use a program card. Now, as you can see, I got three Gaburumon. They're flat out better than this one, so I'm going to use this. Get another Gaburumon. Now, as you can see, I don't have any in the deck anywhere. But what I do have are these. So I'm just going to use this and toss this. That'll pass. I'll summon these three, and then this. And then I'll use a program card. Now, usually, this creature that it would summon would be a little bit weaker. However, because there are more of them, it'll be much better. As you can see, a 28-24. It wouldn't normally be that powerful. Booster 2A. Let's see. And two Gaburumon cards, that, and these. Altogether a really bad hand. These guys like to cheat a lot. And then I'll pass. And we'll battle, and it'll be a tie, but you lose. So, yeah. Who goes first doesn't really matter all that much. And two hard to run, and what do you know, I have one of them in my inventory, so I'll just spawn everything and hope I win. Now I'll summon the Hargurumon. And which one do I want to get rid of? Obviously this one. It's the worst one in the field besides the Hargurumon, but I like that bonus. Unfortunately, he has one of his own. So it'll be another tie. Or I win. That's actually a first. Usually if one of them doesn't die, then it's considered a tie and the other guy wins. No, I go boom, 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 boom. And that's it. And I win, but only barely. Now, this guy seriously cheats. I have Rumon in my inventory and there, so that's 1, 2, 3 And I can get two more. Do this. So. Or I can get one more. Do I really only have one of these? Do you only start with one? Well, I can get one more. And I'll send this to the trash. Man. This is really gimmicky. So, you fairly easily win this first battle, this first round. You think, okay, it's fairly easy. And the realization hits you. You are completely and totally screwed. Now, you don't see this immediately, of course. Oh, no, no, no. Takes you a little while to realize. Get rid of the 1-1. And he passed, apparently. Now, this is actually the first time I've ever won against this guy. He's actually the hardest one to win at. Interesting. Now, you can go here and open booster. As you can see, they stack, so your inventory won't fill up. The cards that you'll get from them suck. Though, this is pretty much the only time you'll see some of these Digimon, rather. Like, Kakuamon. I think you see him. Sharma. As you can see, they didn't have them in the game because their names were impossible to pronounce. And because one of them is made from a toy. Oh, and you also don't see Hawkmon, simply because that's cheesy as hell. To leave. Gotta go. Now there's also a secret down here. Well, there was a secret down here. You just spam the X button over and over and over again while running against this wall area. Just running at different areas of the wall, and you'll eventually get 300 bits. You go down here, run out here, run out here, and back. There we go. Oh, I forgot to switch over. Oh, for the love of. It's typical, trying to rush through this and forget to do something, and then massive amounts of enemies. There was a secret down here, a healing item that I already used. Oh, and I can use Bare Fist. Run over here. And that was all the secrets I showed. I also explained a bit what the stats did. And trained at the gym, which I'll show you later. Do not go down there. You will die. Simple as that. You will die if you go down there. All your Digimon will die. And an ambush. Ambushes sometimes happen and allows the enemies to attack first. I apologize if I seem like I'm rushing, but yeah. The only reason why I'm actually rushing is because I did this all already. Up here, you will die. As you... Oh, can't show you right now. And punch. Punch. Run over here. Get into another battle. And murder everyone. through here, you'll find battles, and there is a really rare battle that can that is very hard and can drop a healing item. As you can see, I'm attacking twice because of high speed, and I level up. Just gonna run around, Pyrosphere. Now then, I'm going to troll around in here. And grab a buckler. I did not show that last time, hooray. In order to equip item, you go into status. You go to the Digimon you want to equip it to. In my case, it's Gilmon. Or maybe not Gilmon, which one was it? Patamon. See equipment. And find the slot that it goes in. For this, it will be left, and it will increase both charisma and defense. It's fairly obvious what most of the things do. Ah, this is the one I was talking about, Betamon. This thing hurts. Apparently I can kill it in one shot, though. It drops much more experience, and it can drop bits. So that's nice. I'm Catherine from Sydney. I will not do... Oh, God. Yeah, this guy will fuck you up. Simple as that. This guy scares me. A lot. He didn't die, and that was 135 damage. Watch this. Watch what happens to my health. What? What is this version? Easier than the US version? That's a first? Hooray, level 4. Run around like a maniac on steroids and speed. Lots and lots of speed. Hello. Die. Seriously, how many of you are there? Hooray, level 4. Now I'm going to show you the training mechanic at the gym. This I did go through before. Give me that money. Running up here, running down, getting stuck. Run up here. Oh crap, I got stuck. Seriously! Stop attacking me! You're going to die. It doesn't matter what level you are going to die. As you can see, I have 10 TP training points down there in the bottom. That's because I did not train at level 3. You get 5 TP at every time you level up. And they're ridiculously useful. Like, for instance, this guy. Very, very low spirit. So, I'm going to train him. I'm only going to go 5, because I don't foresee me using more than that. Just don't do this. Don't do 1 TP. It is useless as fuck. Don't know why it's in the game. There we go. As you can see, it says plus 8, plus 7. Now, each of these counts as their own. Plus 8. And I get a bonus because I got all 3, and plus 10. The fourth one, if you do all 3 in a row, gives a bit more than the rest. Now then, I'm going to increase defense. Why not? Dun dun dun. And I failed one. 1, 2, 3. Dun dun dun. Plus 8. Failed another. If you fail one, you only get... I can't remember what it is, actually. Remember if I see it. Gilmon! Let's see. Yeah, let's boost his defense. I'll see why not. Now, I will be training... If you fail in that third one, you don't get another shot. Let's see. Let's go spirit. And fail. Up by 15. And finally, Patamon. Main stats are spirit and wisdom, so that's mainly what I'm going to be focusing on. Simply because I know this character. And as you can see, the exact same question, 4 times in a row, gets it right 3 times, and fails the 4th time. How? Who knows? That I can understand messing up. It looks hard. But yeah, certain Digimon have a propensity to learn different things. Simply because of how the game works. Not 100% sure on the algorithms, you'd have to look that up. But yeah. Enemies do not scale to level, by the way. Just to let you know. Now I'm going to run back. Running into the inn. Get used to the sound. Trust me, you'll hear it a lot. And wow, does the time fly by. Think this is an episode? Oh, no. Never mind. I'm losing my mind. Thought it was 1 hour 28 minutes, and it's only been 25 minutes. Dear God. Going insane. As you can tell, this move has a red triangle next to it. That's important, because that determines whether it's affected by strength, or spirit, or wisdom. I can't remember which one it is. Yeah. I'll just run around a bit. Punch this thing in the face, even though it says chest. Get some experience, get some money. Yeah. Punch this thing in the chest, or in the kneecap. Which hurts a lot, by the way. Getting hit in the kneecap, it hurts. Seriously, how many of these things are there? Don't go in here while you're low level, by the way. I mean, really low. 1 to 2. You will die by those things. This thing's terrifying. I'm just gonna let it hit me once. Just so you see how much damage it does. seriously. Make a liar out of me, game. Well, in the US version, at least, those things are terrifying. Seriously, that is weird. In the PAL version, in this version that I'm playing, the enemies are stronger. At least, those enemies. The enemies in the beginning here. And some of the... And the card games are easier. Why it's so hard in the US version, I don't know. Those Betamons can drop a healing item. Let's see if it drops here. No. I'm just waiting to level up once. I mean, aha! Level 5. And you get Grismon. I will show one evolution on camera, but I'm gonna get some mana first, just so it's kind of epic at least. Mana heal up. Early on, these trips will pay for themselves. I mean, I can go through 2 battles and pay for all of the members of my party to get a heal. Or almost pay for them all to get a heal. There's a lot of random battles in this game. it's probably more than Pokemon, to be honest. Ah, now then. After I show this, okay, that works. Grismon, the stats are different. For the evolution, they are almost always higher. I think I had one evolution where the speed stat was a little lower, but other than that, it's fine. You generally won't get an evolution, on the main path at least, that's worse. But this... is awesome. And suddenly, I am invincible. But I don't have any tech. A bit upsetting, but I can still smack things about and deal massive damage. As you can see, Grismon flashed a bit. Every evolve that's in a battle gains XP. It can level up as well. As it levels up, it learns new abilities and can unlock new Digivolves. Now, what I said in the first episode, the not quite true about the not being able to evolve out of battle, this. You can choose a Digivolve and turn on Battle Digivolve On. Okay? What that does is as follows. Now, if the game will cooperate for once and give me a battle real quick. There we go. I will automatically come in as the Evolve. I won't have to go into the Digivolve and blah blah blah. Watch that cutscene again, and it frees up a turn to do other things. Like hit the other guy. That's always nice. I will show each Digivolve on camera. At least once. Until you have, until all of your Digimon are level 5, I don't recommend leaving this first area. Simply because there are some fairly powerful Digimon out of this area. If you can do it, I recommend it, because you'll get a lot of XP, you'll get a lot of money. But most people haven't played the game enough to know, okay, I can go into here now. Or, okay, I can go into here. I'm not doing it because I haven't saved recently. So I don't want to risk it. Ah, see, you can get a power charge from those enemies. Those heal 500 HP, and none of our Digimon have that much HP except Kumamon, who, as I said before, is a beast. It is very, very hard to kill a fully leveled Goomamon. Whoops, wrong one. And the heater just turned on. Also, it's cold outside. Like, really cold. I mean, I can't imagine what it's like in Minneapolis right now. Negative 35 with wind chill? Dear God. At least in Delaware, it's slightly more moderate. Nice and just above freezing. Otherwise, it sucks. A lot. Hooray, battle. And Digivolve. Into Groumon. And again, no stat is worse. Not that I can tell, anyway. If there is one that's worse, let me know in the comments below. And boom. Groumon. And now, I get hit. How him biting over my head hurts me, I don't know. But how this hurts him, I understand completely. Boom, 213 damage. Now, sort. Do-do-do-do. Whoops, wrong button. Status. Whoop. No, stop doing that. Digivolve. No! Battle Digivolve on. There we go. As you can see, I'm hammering keys. If you run into a Betamon and you're level 2, like I was the first time of running into it, run away. It will kill you. Very quickly. I don't recommend running around in here when you're level 1. This area over here, I'm okay with running around. Because Betamon rates are really low, and you won't run into those Quagamons. Other than that, though, you will die in here. And that's pretty much the first Kunamon I've seen this entire time. And I've gone through, what, 20 battles so far? Just running around, getting ridiculously close to leveling up. Come on, level up already. Why am I only running into things that give so little XP? Come on, give me something bigger. It's trying to dare me to go into the other area, isn't it? Screw it. I'm chancing it. East Wire Forest. Or, this isn't the area I was thinking, was it? No, it's not. Thankfully, there's an inn right down here. It has a safe spot, has a guy in the basement. You know, fairly normal stuff for an inn. It was this area that I was thinking. Hello there! You're going to murder me horribly. What? Did I just critical hit him? Was it, do you die in one shot? What? Angemon. Bandana. Items. Wrong button. Status. Patamon. Which one has really low defense? Patamon. Kumamon. Gilmon. Okay, so Patamon has the lowest defense. Let's see, equipment. Head. Bandana. It's not the most powerful, but it adds quite a lot of charisma. So, that's nice. Now then, give me a battle that would be epic for this game. I'm begging you. No, not that. Come on. Stop giving me that. Stop! Great, now I'm about to die. Time to run away. Die. Die. What? As you can see, the Grismon leveled up. Sure, when I want battles, it never happens. But when I don't want battles, it always happens. Sometimes I hate this game so much. You know what, screw it. I'm just going to go to the inn down here. Kunamon leveled up again. Seriously. Enough with this nonsense. But there's so many battles at the Digimon that takes forever to level up, leveled up. And to evolve, leveled up. Twice! Die. Run around, run in here, die. down ladders. Just grip. Ooh, that red circle. That's important. Die. This is Angemon, by the way. I said screw it. And as you can see, that level. I hate everything about that, what just happened. Just everything about it. Now, I'm going to show you Digivolve. When I say I'm going to show each of the Digivolves on camera, I mean I'm going to show each of the Digivolves on camera. I don't care what this game makes me do. Die. Angemon will get his ass handed to him. Until you level him up a few times, in which case he becomes the most deadly thing of all time. Stat changes do not happen with the evolutions when they level up. It's more along the lines of... crap, forgot to do that. It's just the abilities that level up, and occasionally you can get other evolutions from them leveling up. Hooray, I don't have to use that horrible Digimon again. There. And now I'm going to run back to the gym. Let me use him! These guys have the strangest hitbox of all time. Now, I am going to raise speed a crap ton, technical term. Now, as you can see, 15. 16. Okay, so I just raised it by... basically what amounts to getting a perfect 5. Another 15. And a 20. Yeah. For Gilmon, I'm gonna go... Spirit and Wisdom, because why not? Whoops. Or just spirit. That works too, I guess. Now, for Patamon, I'm going to upgrade attack. 28. Right. Just so I don't have to beat on enemies for decades. Also, did I mention how cheap this thing actually is? 8 bits each Digimon, okay? The one down there, 16. You're paying double. And that's each Digimon in your party. It's not just, okay, so you're at this, so you pay 8. No, you pay 8 for each Digimon. Or 16 in the case of the one down there. It's ridiculously expensive. And they get more expensive as you go along. Well, sure, you get more money, but your money does not increase that quickly. It's insane. Ah, level up. Learn tech, lightning slash. And here we have our first, well, second elemental if you don't count boom bubble. Tech, lightning slash, thunder damage. As you can see, it's far less flashy than the ability we had before. It's because it's not a it's not a signature attack. This place has some pretty powerful Digimon. Oh dear, Kiwimon. Lightning Slash! Die! Damage. Now, there's one specific Digimon here that's actually pretty threatening. You actually encounter an upgraded version later on in the game, besides Yanmamon. It's not too threatening. It's tough, but it's not threatening in the slightest. At least not if you're the level I am. Because, watch, even if I just smack it, it'll die. Now, up here is important. Now, Pokemon has a long-standing tradition of having the exact same plot every game. Now, people that hate Digimon and only play the first half hour, or first couple hours of it, feel that it is a ripoff of Pokemon, even though they both started at about the same time, because of... Oh, crap, wrong tower. Oh, and these guys have different stuff than the last one. Still not too much better. Because of this plot line. If you run through here... Crap. Talk to this kid, rather. Sir, your leader is training at the Protocol Ruins. It's northwest of here. There are badges in this game that you get from beating gym leaders. A lot of people find that that's ripping off of Pokemon. The plot gets a lot more complicated later on. It's actually one of the better RPG plots out there. Double power. See, there's abilities that do the exact same thing as those items. Attack, double power, increases your attack power. It's rather useless. And level up. Pressing the wrong button to pause. Use to Mardek. Attack. And just, even with me failing twice, even with Patamon failing twice at that challenge, it's still strong, it's still gained enough to just wreck things. Now, up here at the die. Stop spawning. Up here at the Protocol Ruins, there's a gym leader. However, first, I believe I can battle someone. Now, a lot of people don't like this game purely because of all of these random battles. I can't blame them. They get on my nerves. So I imagine that it must get on people who don't even, who are not a particularly great fan of these type of RPGs, that it would certainly get on their nerves. And I have no doubt about it. But thankfully I'm playing on an emulator and I can speed up everything. Oh, god damn it, it's a card battle. I need more blue, so I will draw a blue card. A basic blue card. This guy, that'll do. And I'll trash him. No, I'll pass. So as you can see, you can manipulate certain cards and certain types. Yes, I'll put this in the field. Begin combat phase. Yes, I'll use this. On that guy, because why not? Pet him on to the field, blah blah blah. And die. I actually hate going first. By the way, simply because it prevents you from seeing what the other person is doing beforehand, so you could lose a creature on the field that's on the field that you upgraded, let's say, and you'd have no way of stopping it. Alright, I'm going up here, and first off, sleeping in the inn, because I'm lazy. Going through here, and seeing if I can join this yet. Hey, I can. Guys, but that, blah, 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 blah. I don't know, I just talked to this guy a couple times. Ah, damn it. Why aren't my Digimon considered cool? Because you suck, that's why. I wasn't asking you. Jerk. I wish this recording was better. I really do. I'm sorry. I sincerely apologize for the first episode. That was terrible. There is no excuse for how bad that is. Except one, and I'll use it now. Air Blast. Hooray. I can actually use an ability that will kill things now. Hooray. Die. Hooray! It kills it. And then it levels up. Ambush. Oh, an ambush is also spawn you in without the Digivolve up. But it doesn't really matter because Bare Fist kills all. Because punching them in the chest hard enough to kill them is normal. And die, spider. These are the first enemies in the game that can actually poison you, so be careful about that. Also, if they drop spider silk, don't use it in battle. You can use it for a fairly decent item that's kind of useful. Not sure how useful it is, but it's pretty good for grinding experience. I hate going through here. Thank God for speed up. Aha! I couldn't describe the path out of there even if I had a guide. Bare Fist! Punch it in the face. Punch it in the face. Again, punching things hard enough to kill them. Badass. Spiderweb. Yeah, that's what I was talking about. Now, this area can hold some pretty powerful enemies. Thankfully, you don't have to fight them yet. Or, you do have to fight them. But, you don't have to fight the boss here. At least, not yet. Just need to find the right guy. Believe he's over here. Don't talk to him unless you want to die. Minotauromon. He's scary. Level 10. Learn tech. Whirlwind. Gumamon. Level up. Ah, so used to Grimardek. Now run through here, run back here. Okay, now then, as you can see, here he's using this gang, this thing, and this thing. He doesn't use these in the main battle. Don't ask me why. You can't actually get that team at the moment. Simply because you haven't proc'd the right guy yet. But you cannot get Vemon yet. You have to run through this maze again. Aw, crap. Thankfully, getting out is easier than getting in. Or so I thought. Oh, you can drop down these, by the way. Forgot to mention that. Oh crap, there's an inn right over there, isn't there? Because I need to heal up. Yeah, sometimes this speed up makes my life so much harder. There we go. Well, this has been an extra long episode. Another episode will be uploaded today. If this uploads second, it's probably because of how long it is. So I apologize for that. Yeah. Next time, we battle dinosaurs, talk to a guy in a basement, and go back and talk to the gym leader. Apparently the game thinks I've spent 5 hours in this game. I've actually spent much less. Thanks to the speed up thing, Turbo. Have a good day.